3-4 years ago, working on a project in Peru. We're both designers, and we were paired together working on a development type project. In our experiences going through this project and our other experience, we kind of saw a gap in the market. Oh, we should be. This is Pacasmayo. Just a small town, and this is the small town we live in, and you can just kind of see how rural we are. We're up in a northern area of Peru. So we first started working together formally on a project with a group of 300 women in northern Peru. We built a business together because we had identified this problem between the market businesses who wanted to create really cool and innovative and interesting product, getting that product to the point that a community with very little social development and education would be able to sustain and produce and market. There's a big gap in the middle that few entities were really addressing.
So, I mean, the first big step that we had to do is like actually go there and stay meeting with to work with the people from the beginning, like they've checked in the basics. So, like from teaching how to learn or like stuff. Basic working methods to like learn how to read a spec sheet or like instructions that you know like work for working together. So yeah, the biggest difference from the other projects that we worked in was that we couldn't work remotely, like from Toronto or from Lima, from any big city. We actually thought that it was much better to be there working with them and to like learn more from the experience, to be able to actually make a change. So yeah, so it was very inspiring to be there like close, and we got the chance to like really see what where all the traditions that were around that we could you know, grab to like start exploring on the techniques that regularly we wouldn't be able to like look at in other places. So to actually start working with those techniques and to do something to you know create work or create a profit out of it or benefit, we understood that we had to set up like a system to work with you know like the international market and the communities. So we came with this way of working. It was like building these new relationships of collaboration. We were depending on the government and like private institutions that would actually like to help, because if we wanted to take the product out to the market wouldn't invest in teaching people how to like read. So we had to figure out that, and we positioned ourselves here as like just articulating all the stakeholders. You know, we had to like deal with the community, with the market, the private companies and the government all took like a place into the building of this new collaboration to you know to support that bridge and make this transaction between the market and the community happen and happen with this new value of a product that came from what we'll talk about, which is the fishing nets, which wasn't an easy task.
So when we began this business with this kind of, we recognize that we were the bridge. We focused, our main intention is that we want to connect forward-thinking markets with innovative, high-quality, crafted objects. We mainly try to look at three principles to do that. We focus on design, first and foremost. We're designers, we can't help it. And so you know, it's amazing to be able to explore these really interesting, innovative, ancient techniques and then see how we can create products that the market would like, so that there is an economic interest in these products. But as much as a product can be beautiful and well-made and absolutely high quality, unless someone is buying it and connecting with that and interested, it doesn't really mean anything. So we found a client who was interested in exploring these techniques. We started a first run of production. We had an order of 500 bags to figure out not only how to make this beautiful high quality thing, but also how to organize together. Our second pillar is really surrounding social innovation. So how do we connect these two distinct worlds and filter an Andean identity into a desirable product? And then the most important part that I don't think we realized when we first started, but was the empowerment whole world. We, as much as we could say, okay, great, here's the bag, here's the market, there was a huge gap in terms of being able to execute something like this. We would distribute a bag and say, okay, here you go, here's all the yarn, here's the spec sheet, we review it together, and if someone in the process of us walking away and coming back had a doubt or a fear or didn't understand something, we would so often find that they would quit in the middle. They would walk away. They would be kind of afraid to maybe speak up and say that they didn't understand. So we had to work on confidence building and basic training in terms of reading spec sheets and break down our specs to be in a language that was really understandable for someone who may not necessarily read or write at all. So it was a really interesting process for all of us using design and social innovation, trying to land at this meeting point, this bridge that's effective to make a whole business work on this. So we eventually, we've been doing this now for 3 years, it's going well, we've kind of established these pillars and our methods and it's very exciting to see it come together. We would not have imagined that we would be working with fishermen along the way. So just less than a year ago, we had a client interested in this stylish market item, and I'll let Mauricio tell you about our fisherman project.
So we met Jose. Jose came to the workshop one day. He had his boat broken. He was the father of one of the weavers that we were working with, and he started. I mean, we already have seen him. We were talking about like the weaving process he made for the fishing nets, and it was super interesting. We felt like we wanted to use it, and now that he had like all the time in the world for us, it was a perfect moment to start making all those strides come together. And so we started making some prototypes. We started talking with him, trying to get some more fishermen interested in the weaving of bags or other products than fishing nets. So we started talking to the guys around that felt the same interest. The fishing community has this moment in which they can go on ships when the swell is high and like the port closes because it's unsafe to go out fishing. Well, artisanal fishing. So there's gaps to alternate in the way they work. You know, when they can't go, they can certainly sit down and start weaving. So that made it like really attractive for both of us. And but what they had to do is have to start teaching the women to incorporate this fishing net into the workshop, the system that we had. But from both places, like they had to teach, but then they would have to submit to the system created or run by the women. And that was a challenge because they wouldn't admit that, we live in a place where like men are like men by the houses, there's a disposition of power between them, and they felt ashamed to work at the workshop floor on the orders of the women that we were working with at the moment. And so that was one of the biggest gaps we had to like let this go or move further as an actual opportunity for them to like make use of this technique into fashion or into like a different possibility rather than use it on fishing nets.
So we landed with a really cool sample. There are some here if anyone wants to touch them later. But yeah, it was a really fascinating process. This netting technique was something that no one gave any value to. It was just something they did as nets were becoming more and more industrial. Even less fishermen themselves knew how to do these complicated knotting techniques. So they were excited to explore how this could have a new future with them. So we wanted to take a moment to reflect on this and say, you know, okay, we made a cool sample. They work together. What does this mean for the future of work? What is the impact here? In terms of a cultural advantage, we have an Andean tradition here kind of coming to light in a product, you know, being valued. If the men can't go out fishing, they have, you know, a few other opportunities or to make enough money for the day or the month, whereas this is a really nice option that they can do from their home on their own time. Empowerment, it was fascinating watching this old fisherman with a slow, methodic, lovely teaching, a natural teacher type person, come into our world and slowly teach and explain to hundreds of our groups how to make this bag and how to translate that technique into a profitable item. And the most surprising one really was that we realized along the way, oh yes, the women are in charge here, and you will have to go and review your work and make sure that it's okay, and if it's not, deal with that and come back to us when it's time. They really sat there saying, no, I'll work at home, that's no, thank you. But now they very actively are in it together, and it's been really cool to see that a positive example of a shift in that gender power balance in the community.
It's been about the possibilities that we are enabled here. It may be seen as something kind of logical, but the setup that we had to make in the place was that we had to unite like all these sort of concepts of like applying a weaving technique into like the bags, because they were not before done by like regular weavers. It was done by fishermen, so they wouldn't really consider that to be like a opportunity that could come to life. So it was just like this interaction between them and us and all the stakeholders around, including the clients, that made it come true. And it opens a new window for this community to like start looking at those traditions of whether it's like from the women that women do or men do, and take that as an advantage or as a resource that could find a way of keeping alive and actually getting money, or you know, help to the income of them through this platform, through this setup of new ways of collaboration, or like looking at these traditional things in a different way so they can fit into the future of work.
Thank you.